Hey guys, this is Austin with Walton's TV, and welcome to Meet Gistics, Episode 1. First up today, we're taking a quick look at a brand new item for us. It's the VacMaster VP112S. This is going to be our most economical chambered vacuum sealer that we offer. It comes in at $549. It's a small enough unit that it's still a home vacuum sealer, but it's big enough that we still get a full 12-inch seal bar in here, and the biggest vacuum pouch we can fit in here is a 12x14. So at a 12x14, you're still going to be able to fit a lot of product in here at one time. One of the coolest features I'm really excited about this unit for is that it has a special marinating feature that quickly allows food to achieve an optimal flavor infusion through its marinade cycle. It's going to alternate back and forth between a state of vacuum and a state of rest, and you can set that to run from anywhere from 9 to 99 minutes. Make sure you guys keep an eye out for our Walton's TV YouTube channel to see our full product review on this coming soon. Next up for a product spotlight, just because we're right in the middle of grilling season, we got a few things that you guys, if you're grilling right now, you've got to be using. We've got nonstick grilling baskets, nonstick grilling sheets, and then also nonstick grilling mats that are just a solid mat instead of the mesh. These things are awesome though. Anything you're cooking on the grill that's small or might stick to the grates on your grill or might fall through, I use these, especially the basket, a ton for vegetables, kebabs, fish, anything like that that you can't put normally on your grill. And then the mats, you can cook all kinds of things on these. You can do pizzas, you can do bacon, even cookies, anything like that that you need a more solid surface for, but you want to cook it on your grill, these are awesome for. Three of these are available on our website at waltonsinc.com for $12.99, so they're very cheap and very inexpensive. Finally, meat hacks. Whenever you guys are making sausage, whether that's snack sticks, summer sausage, brats, or another type of smoked sausage, make sure you use as cold a meat as possible. One of the things that we'll do before we're ready to make sausage is take the meat and put it in the freezer for about an hour or so. We don't want to leave it in there too long and actually freeze it, but we want it to be as cold as possible when we start making sausage. The colder the meat, the better we are going to have of a grind and a better particle definition. It's also going to be good for meat safety. The lower the temperature of the meat, the less likely we are to have bacteria grow. And lastly, protein extraction is more efficient at colder temps. So whenever you're making sausage, always remember cold meat is really helpful for you. Please subscribe to our Walton's TV YouTube channel, like this video, and leave us a comment or suggestion below. As always, visit our website at waltonsinc.com to find everything but the meat. That's all for today. Thanks for watching Meat Gistics. I'm Austin with Walton's TV. We'll see you guys next time.